Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. SwiftUI, we need to talk. Okay, when SwiftUI was announced a few days ago in WWDC, I was like, what? It was the awesomest thing that I ever seen, and still it is, but we need to talk about learning SwiftUI and how you should approach all of this topic, because you should hear this before you start picking up SwiftUI. Well, I have jotted down some of my thoughts here and I will go through each and every one of them. So yeah, I don't miss any of my what I want to say. So you are going to see a lot of videos about SwiftUI, but you really need to learn this, or do you really need to learn this shiny tool right now? And that is why I made this video's title, Don't Learn It Just Yet. Because just think of it, do you really need to learn this beta software? Do you really need to do this right now? And I have been seeing yesterday Killer Loco's video, and it kind of resonated with my thoughts. And yeah, let me just run through it. I'm just going to play you a 1 minute slot, and let's just move forward from that. So here we go.
And if you are a content creator and you are happening, if you're happening to watch this and you are a content creator, whether that's YouTube, podcasts, articles, you know, whatever medium that you're choosing to release content, make sure that you're not giving the impression to our community, especially for the beginners and the aspirers, make sure you're not giving that impression that SwiftUI is the only way to go, you know, that you have to know SwiftUI to get a job. The biggest thing that we need to promote are best practices to help get our aspiring and junior developers up to the next level. And same thing with intermediate and advanced developers. This is a little bit harder, but we're trying to get everybody up to the next level. And we want to make sure that we're keeping the information clear.
Yeah, so I'm going to stop that right there. Nice face, Kilo. So, we as, let's so call it, publishers on YouTube, we kind of have a responsibility, and it depends on who you ask, but I believe that my responsibility is to teach you and for you to evolve from one step of the ladder to the next. And when it comes to SwiftUI, it's kind of strange because it's still in beta and you can use it, but you really can't. And let me just go through what I mean by that. UIKit is still much better and, most importantly, more stable. Remember, SwiftUI is still in beta, and yeah, beta software will have bugs, and yeah, it is expected of beta versions to have bugs, and it does not cover everything. It has some new API that you will spend time learning, but just think about, do you really need to learn this today? Do you need to deploy this next day? Well, no, because SwiftUI will be available only, hopefully, with iOS 13. So, because SwiftUI will be available only on iOS 13, available only this fall, you don't really need to jump right in, because yeah, Apple just announced this and I really need to learn this. Remember, you don't have to basically learn SwiftUI. There are a lot more important things iOS wise, like architecture or state management, or what is MVVM, or all of these are much more important than you to jump right into SwiftUI. And yeah, why I'm telling this is because, of course, you will learn You will see a lot of SwiftUI tutorials, videos on YouTube. And there are a lot right now. And you just want to consider if you take the time to jump on this. Now, next up, because SwiftUI is in beta, it has its limitation and it is buggy. Yeah, of course. There are a lot of loose ends that still need to be fixed. Yeah, just so you know. Yes, SwiftUI is the future and you should prepare for it. But today you need to learn what you can already use today. And this is a big one because, yeah, you have to prepare. You have to be prepared for the future. But just think about the new API. It may be changed in 3 months' time or let's say half a year's time when you will actually use it in a production app. Now, if you just want to tinker with it, go ahead, but do take time and think about this. Your main job is, and this is what I believe, and hopefully you do, problem solving. You cannot solve problems with beta frameworks. Now, as a developer, I believe that my main job is problem solving, not to learn any new language or know all of the languages or all of the frameworks. My job is to solve real world problems with the help of course, development. And yeah, the question comes, can you solve problems with beta software that is buggy and not available yet? If not, then you most probably shouldn't learn it just right now. Now, let's move forward. Your biggest asset is your time, of course. Why learn something today that you cannot use and will most probably change and evolve till the time it will be released to the public? You can pick up on SwiftUI then, within days or weeks. And of course, I will be releasing then some tutorials, and yeah, there will be a lot. So you don't have to learn this right now because maybe it will change. Your best quality, and I'm talking about in the perspective of development, being in a team or at a company, time well spent. Now, product managers love these kind of people and developers, because it doesn't really matter if you sit there, let's say, half an hour and you type in a lot of code, or you sit there and let's say for 3 hours or 6 hours and you type in a little code, but that code works better than the one that was typed in, let's say, in half an hour. So yeah, beta versions are broken. I had to, yeah, this is my experience. Unfortunately, I had to uninstall Xcode 11 beta and spent 4 hours fixing a CocoaPod issue created by installing Xcode 11 beta in the first place. So let me just click on this and show you what I needed to figure out and basically do after I have installed, of course, and uninstalled Xcode 11 beta. So yeah, these are 15 steps that I needed to create in turn to be able to push to my CocoaPod on GitHub. So yeah, pretty frustrating. 4 hours lost, in my opinion. Okay, there you go, Kilo. Again, huge thanks for Kilo Loco to raising his voice, because yeah, yesterday when I watched his video, I was thinking that yeah, I should do a video on this too. Okay, let's move forward. Beta versions do have bugs, and they had bugs last year and they will have bugs next year. Stop wasting time each year after WWDC to install beta software and manage crashes afterwards. So it's a huge time saver if you don't do this. And yeah, I did it last year and the year before that, and kind of this year too, but no more. When new things come out, it can be extremely tempting to jump on the bandwagon, and it can be extremely difficult to judge whether you should put some time into learning it or just wait a bit. And yeah, as a new developer or aspiring developer, you don't really know. And yeah, this is just my advice. Just leave it a little bit till it settles down. Don't just chase the new shiny thing. Focus on your goal as a developer, and this is serve your code base best. And yeah, this is another good one, because your ultimate goal is to write better code. So yeah, it performs better, it reads better, and yeah, you can manage it later on better. And do not turn to the next shiny thing and waste time eventually. As a rule of thumb, your app should support version n-1. Now, that means that if the current version is iOS 12, then most probably all of the companies will support n-1. That means iOS 12 and iOS 11. Now, that means that even when, let me just delete this, even when iOS 13 comes out and hopefully SwiftUI comes with it, you still need to support iOS 12 that does not have SwiftUI, only UIKit. You need to be prepared to handle this if you choose to implement SwiftUI. Of course, SwiftUI and UIKit go hand in hand, so it will be some sort of not that hard to use both, but do consider that it's SwiftUI will be mainstream maybe when iOS 14 or iOS 15 comes out. Now, less code doesn't necessarily mean better code. One can write garbage regardless of the number of lines they write, and this is so true. Like, okay, SwiftUI, less code, but yeah, is it better code? Well, it depends on what you are using it for, and that means that you have to think about what you are building and what your main goal is. So I don't know, maybe, well, most probably it will be supported, but currently I can't see the UI temp bar controller. Where is it in SwiftUI? It will be there, or if it already isn't in. But yeah, there are a lot of loose ends there. Less code, yeah, let me move on. You are not hired or going to be hired because you write less code. You are hired because you solve problems. And that comes back to my other idea that I talk about. You solve problems. You build out applications that solve problems. And yeah, that is the most important thing that companies are looking for in a developer. The sovereign, the problem solving capability. So, declarative syntax is awesome. So, duck UI. Okay, now, what I really love about SwiftUI is the declarative syntax. And so, I'm launching a new CocoaPod, and it is called duck UI. Let me just jump right there. And this is SwiftUI for UIKit. Well, kinda. And yeah, I am going to build out duck UI, so you can basically use the sort of syntax that SwiftUI uses in UIKit, because UIKit is well tested and proven and it works awesome. But with this new shiny declarative syntax of SwiftUI, you might be tempted to move all the way with to SwiftUI, but you don't really know how to use it in UIKit. And that is why I'm building out this duck UI, so you can use that declarative syntax with UIKit. So go ahead, stay tuned for this development. If you like it, star it. I don't mind. Well, I really do love if somebody stars my repo. And of course, clone it and test it out, or just add it to your project via CocoaPods. So yeah, that's a duck UI, and yeah, let me just scroll a little bit down. So yeah, so that's duck UI. Now, it's kind of your turn. Swift UI is out, and go ahead, and if you prefer to, go ahead and play with it and get a feeling of it, but make sure you don't waste a lot of time, because it's basically kind of not that useful to learn just right now. So SwiftUI doesn't exactly change everything just yet. So If you did like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell so you get notified of new videos as they do come out. And what do you think of all of this? Please do comment down below, and I'm really eager to hear your thoughts. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.